This occasion of New Year, I wanted to share a very great use case for you. So basically, today's video, I'm going to show how you can use the power of AI to write personalized message. So we have the data in our Google Sheet. So what I have done is I just have the name of the people. So first of all, I wrote some names and I wrote the comment about what I know about them or like how we met, how we are connected and things of that nature. And the last option is the message. Now, if you're wondering how you're going to send these messages from Google Sheet, don't worry, you don't have to manually type them out. You can use a tool called Epic Testing App, which can help you send messages from Google Sheet. So you can freely check it out. But let's see how we are going to do that. Writing a personalized message with AI, with the name and some comment. So I have written the comment already. I don't want to waste time showing you a writing and thinking. So here we have the data and I'm going to write sheet AI. So this is a simple prompt which I was writing. I was like, write, oh, I misspelled it by the way. But the good part of the AI is it will still write a good, don't worry about miss, like if you spell something wrong or something, I'll fix it just to get a better prompt. So basically what I wrote as a prompt was write a thoughtful, caring happy new year message to, then I provided the name and then space knowing this. So the reason why I said knowing is because I kept the comment very general. I didn't specify it ko, oh, I'm not only going to mention in the comment how we met, or I'm going to only mention how close we are, things of that nature. The comment is very general, so I wanted to keep it like that. That's why I wrote in the prompt knowing. If I was a bit more informative or like I know more like what that column have specifically, then I could like write like that. So I wrote, write a thoughtful, caring, happy new year message to James, knowing, comment, and then I wrote message. Many people have been asking me how I write better prompt, how they can write a better prompt to get what they want, get the results they want from the AI. So one of the tips which I wanted to share with you is I always end my prompts with this. So the whole thing about this AI is to understand that this AI is not a bot. It's not a AI which is going to understand. It's not, you're not having a chat conversation. It's an AI which does the text completion. The whole purpose of the AI is to predict what text is going to come next. So what we are going to do when we are writing a prompt is to make it very clear what we expect to be next. So rather than just, if I don't write the message, I'm just leaving it on AI to predict what is going to come off next. And that gives a lot of variety of chances. When I wrote it like message and then colon, that decreases the probabilities or the possibilities. And hence we get a better results. I hope that helps you write a better prompt. If it does, let me know. And also if you have any prompt requests, make sure to comment them down below. I'll help you with that. Getting back to it. So I wrote, write a thoughtful and caring happy new year message to this and knowing that. And if I hit enter, within less than a second, we have that. I'm just going to, okay, how does that work? Oops, I don't know. So I'll just put it like this. So I'm so proud of you taking the challenge of building an app, deploying Notion Pages as a website. I'm sure you have hard work and dedication will pay off in the coming year. Wishing you all the best for 2021. So I did one thing wrong. I didn't mention the AI, but new year, the year which is coming. So it, I'm not saying these are going to be 100% perfect, because obviously if you don't give it the data, it's just going to try to put something similar like a templated one. So you can just update the year. I don't think it's a very big problem, but let's see, let's continue. Wishing you all the best for 2021 and beyond. May the new year brings you success. So one thing which you learned about AI right now is AI does not know what the time is. AI does not know anything, right? You don't expect the AI to be like a Google. It's not a Google. It cannot Google things for you. It cannot think, okay, this is the time. It cannot think, okay, if you give it a website URL, it cannot scrape the data. The data you provide is the data it's going to continue the prediction for. It's an AI completion algorithm. It's not a robot. It's not a chat you're having with an AI. It's simply text completion algorithm. Let's continue. So it says, wishing you all the best for 2021 and beyond. May the new year brings you success, joy, and plenty of opportunities to make your dreams come true. Here's the to the prosperous and fulfilling year ahead. Let's do this for others. Okay, so for Robert, I wrote, I met him in the gym once and we have our hi hellos day to day. So this is just like, even the English, I'm not sure if this hi is like perfect. It should be H-I, right? I misspelled it because that's how I write. It's just like many people write like H-Y quickly. Like not, I'm not saying I write hi always like this, but just AI understands. Don't worry about spelling mistakes. Okay, so what is it wrote? Happy New Year, Robert. I hope this year brings you all the joy and success you deserve. I'm glad you have been able to greet each other in the gym, and I look forward to seeing you there again soon. Wishing you a year full of good health, happiness, and prosperity. Again, if you are sending a message to someone you know this much, this is enough. Okay, so continue for John. I wrote, like, I first met John when I needed help with code. From then onwards, we have been connected and things like that. So let's see how it have written that. I'm so grateful for the connection we have formed over the past year. I'm thankful for the help you have given me with coding, and I'm excited to continue working together on any new projects. I look forward to meeting you more often in the new year to create more meaningful work together. Wishing you happy, healthy, prosperous 2021. Moving on. We have this... Okay, is it like, I don't know, let's see. So basically, Linda is a female name, so I was just thinking, like, is it like, it seems to be the biggest one, or maybe it's structured properly. It's like an email somehow. Okay, let's see. Okay, Happy New Year message. Okay, maybe that's what AI is thinking. Or maybe I said it, she's like a founder or something. That's why it's more of like a structured. Let's see. So, dear Linda, Happy New Year. I hope this brings you and your family health, joy, and success. I wanted to take a moment to thank you for giving me the opportunity to work with you at SheCan. It was an honor to be considered for the position. I'm grateful for your trust in me. I'm looking forward to continuing our work together in the new year. I know that your leadership, SheCan, will continue to grow and positive impact in the lives of many. Wishing you a wonderful 2021. So, one thing which I'm trying to understand is, I didn't told the AI that, oh, she's a founder, writer, and like, in the comment, I mentioned that it's like we got connected like regarding a hiring thing. So it's not like we don't have a friends kind of a relation. So I kind of think the AI understood that somehow. I don't know. I would love to know how it worked for you. But I like this particular response really well. The only thing I feel like all of these responses so far, the only thing bad was like this 2021. So it wrote 2021. I could have easily improved that by just saying, write a Happy New Year message for 2023. But yeah, let's go. So let's see the next one. We have happy. We met on Twitter regarding mutual interest in AI. From then on, we share. Okay. So Happy New Year, Barbara. It's been such a pleasure getting to know. So just see this for yourself. Okay. I'm not making this up. This is the first time I'm using this prompt for all of these. I actually tried it for like I entered it for once and it generated the prompt. But for all the others, I have generated for the first time. So I'm really like happy about the responses because you can see like for this Linda it generated how I expect it to be. It should not be very informal. It should not be like a friend. It should be a bit formal like that, where my name is there. Because, I mean, she's a founder. She contacted me. So it's not a good relationship. I don't even remember my name, right? So giving a name there. But on the messages, where I'm saying we met on like interest regarding AI and we talk. So in that case, that's not an interest, which is where she might not know my name. She will know my name. We are connected. So in that, there's no name. There's no option to put my name. So I'm really happy even like with just a short prompt, I was able to generate such a great response. Let's continue. So Happy New Year, Barbara. It's been such a pleasure getting to know you over the past through our mutual interest in AI. I'm so thankful for conversation we had and the knowledge we have shared. Amazing. Here's to the even more exciting year ahead of us, continuing to explore the possibilities of AI. Wishing you a wonderful 2021. Okay, so I hope these examples were good and you liked them. If you did, make sure to give it a try. Visit sheetai.app and install the app, enter your friend's name and enter some sort of comments about how you met, how deep the connection is, how much you know each other and things of that nature, and see how AI generates a personalized message for you. Do let me know in the comments and we'll see you in the next video.